Let's just quickly move on to the students. Well, we have a new TP over here, and she's curious how we can help the kids over here. Great. I hope a lot of you have taken the quiz that we basically just asked you to kind of take. That is the WARC questionnaire. And we'll just quickly launch a question around that. But in the meantime, we'll just quickly get started with this particular presentation. Awesome. So here is the thing. Pam, Shweta, you want to take over?
Sure. So I think I had earlier seen this one question on the chat as well, that how would we try and do mock interview sessions across before somebody appears for a real interview. So Pramp is a great tool that enables that to happen. Mahiresh, if we can just show the Pramp app. Yes, so this is the tool. And what you could do is if you click on start a practice session, a lot of companies today, they ask case-based interview questions. And that's to evaluate the critical thinking skills, the problem-solving skills, as Sudarshan sir also mentioned earlier. And what happens is when you click on start a practice session, you get paired up with anybody across the globe who will interview you, and you can interview them back as well. So let's say if you're doing a new practice interview and you click on product case study, so you can select whatever slot you want to, and then you confirm and schedule. So based on this, what happens is you get assigned a case study, which is, let's say here it's LinkedIn onboarding. And then there are a set of questions that are asked to you. So how would you improve LinkedIn sign up onboarding process? And then there are several sub questions asked as well. And the learners have to think about this and, have an ideal solution in mind as well. And then they ask this question to the peer on the other side. Similarly, the peer asks them another question. So this just helps them practice much more before they get ready for the real interview. And this is free of cost. So all the learners can just keep taking as much advantage of this as possible. Okay, perfect. The next one is Coda. So this tool has, again, multiple use cases. We use at GreyAtom, we use Coda to maintain a wiki of sorts. So basically, you have these complex, functionalities and complex algorithms and complex additional learning content. So what we do is we use this tool to organize all of that together in one place and any additional resources beyond the textbooks. So let's say, for example, we know that data structures and algorithms or in civil, in mechanical, what are the typical kind of placement resources that get asked? We could use this kind of tool to organize all of these resources together. So we will also see how we are doing it. So Mahiresh, if you can open that up. Yes. So these are all different topics. And this is the GreyAtom wiki page for data science. And if we go into any of this, so let's say we go into getting started with Python. So in addition to whatever is there on our platform, these are all external resources that we have combined together so that the learners can, have this as one-stop destination for anything that they want to know about this. So similarly, I see a great use case for this Coda tool to be the one-stop place for all the placement resources. GitHub. So, okay, GreyAtom. So we have...
I think it's GitHub.
It's GitHub, okay, perfect. So GitHub is basically a repository where people store their code. And even beyond that, that's a place where, a lot of open source projects are built as well. And this is a repository, where we are using GitHub to have our learners attempt certain projects. And then when they attempt these projects, their projects go back on GitHub as well. So today, you know, when a recruiter is onboarding someone, is evaluating someone, it's beyond their resume. They also want to look at the person's GitHub profiles and how frequently are they contributing to the open source community as well. So this is one of our learners, Bhavesh, and that's his GitHub profile, which looks pretty active. So this definitely wins brownie points. Also, I think as a resource for all your learners, GitHub has opened up several free programs for people who are, you know, with an .edu domain, or, you know, they are students at this point in time. So if you scroll down, Mayresh. Yeah, so these are all the tools that students can access at no cost via the GitHub education pack, and they can keep upskilling themselves. Medium. So Medium is a place where people blog a lot. So, I mean, again, this is branch agnostic, technology agnostic. This is where, let's say, students have built their final year projects and they want to share like a story of how they started, what were the roadblocks during the process of that final project building, how did they collaborate with each other, and finally, what's the outcome. So this is a place they can keep blogging about anything that they learn or about anything that they have just read about. So this is, let's say, for example, this Medium account is of a person called Srishti Savla. She's been a Grey Atom learner, and she kept blogging about every new thing that she learned or the projects that she built. And this, genuinely, this was a phenomenal thing that helped her get a very, very good job, because you, even beyond the certificate, or even beyond, you know, just her pure demonstration of skill, something like this demonstrated that she could also be a good storyteller. And external publications, like Towards Data Science, that's like a very good publication, globally known. They approached her to write for their publication as well. So it's definitely powerful when learners want to get good jobs.
Right, so we have TED-Ed. TED is a very, very tiny, very, very sweet tool. We'll just quickly have a look at it. So it is something that facilitates micro-learning. How about you have an email in your inbox every single day on a topic that you like? So if you're a student, the student can just click here and the student can say that I want one email every single day and it should just educate me about some topic or some subject. And it is a very, very simple thing. So really, really very simple. You can get started with this totally free and it doesn't take much of your time, but I think, but just expands your horizon. So very simple, sweet, short tool. Right, so quickly moving on from here, we have Jupyter and Stack Overflow. Shweta, if you can just.
Yes, so Jupyter is basically a tool where you code up, build your code here, you build data, you export data sets here, and then immediately you can see the results as well. Stack Overflow, I think we all know that that's a place where developers go to when they face any kind of errors. So there is a very interesting integration built between Jupyter and Stack Overflow. So what we always say and tell our learners is that whenever you get stuck, you know, your first resort should not be asking for help. Your first resort should be debugging things yourself and trying to find out why it did not work in the first place. So something like this now really comes to their help. So let's say a learner made a mistake while writing this code, and instead of type, they said type FGH, okay? And now you're running this code, and definitely this is gonna give us an error. Now, how do you debug this? Sometimes, you know, you just Google it up, but then there is this search Stack Overflow integration that's inbuilt within Jupyter. So if you click on that, it really takes you to the Stack Overflow thread where exactly this kind of a question has been answered. And that's how then, you know, people can debug and resolve issues themselves. And this just helps them be better problem solvers.
Great. So very nice, Shweta, very small tool, but very effective, connecting Jupyter and Stack Overflow. So quickly moving on, we have rescue time and stay focused. So again, life is, full of distractions. We really, really have to stay focused. We need to know how we spend our time. I think someone did speak about time doctor and everything, something very much similar to that, but just hitting nail right on the head. This is one tool that tells me how am I spending my time. I'm able to classify this. I'm able to look at it. I know how I spend my time, so I choose to spend my time better. Each of the students can share this, and you can show them the mirror that, you are doing a lot of Instagram, a lot of TikTok. Cut that down, and let's come back to this particular thing. Stay Focused is a Chrome extension. Super awesome, very simple. You install this, it will tell you that you are spending a lot of time on Facebook, and you just have to put a lock that you will only spend 30 minutes on Facebook. After 30 minutes, it will not allow you to open Facebook only. And there is one more really awesome feature over here which says nuclear option. Once you click that, it will not allow you to open anything but your things that are managed or help to focus on getting yourself more productive. Great. So quickly moving on, I think we have reached at the fag end, and we have also at 5:02. So quickly moving on, we have GMAS. We already looked at this at some point in time. So we'll just move on from here. We have JobScan. So Shweta, if you can just help us with JobScan.
Absolutely. So I think you guys will find this to be a very, very relevant tool. What this does is basically each time there's a new JD, and a company is always asking for different things. And what we do sometimes is we keep our resume same, static. And that doesn't help us because the company is always trying to fulfill that JD and not really match us for that job. So this is a tool which where, this is a resume, let's say, for a person, and then that there's a JD also. So this is a JD of a front-end web developer, front-end engineer. And now, if I want to see as a TPO before sharing it with that company, or even if that learner wants to see how good, bad his resume is and how should he improve that resume, here is a very quick thing you do. You upload that resume on one side and the job description on the other and just start a scan. So then it's going to tell us, where are some of the mistakes, what kind of skills are not getting covered. So how much is the skills match? Format, has that been any good or not? What are the missing skills? So, you're missing 6 important skills, and then the list of those skills are as per below, whether the education is a match or not, whether headings are well formatted or not. So it just gives us so many recommendations that we can implement and make our resume much better suited to a particular job.
Great. So I think final on, we have one of the tools that are very interesting. So Shweta, you want to help?
Yeah, sure. So this is GLabs for, everyone that's seeing it for the first time. This is the product that GreyAtom has built internally. We have a 12-member engineering team that's constantly improving on top of what is here. So this is the learning platform that across our programs, whether it is front-end, whether it is data science or anything else, this is the platform that gets used to go through the programs, attempt assignments, attempt projects, and finally get outcomes. So if you go inside any of the topics, the philosophy that we've always gone ahead with is larger problem solving, business problem solving. So at the beginning of this, there would always be a visual intuition, there would always be a mathematical intuition, and then we would make sure that people are practicing things to progress, to make progress. So here there's an explanation of something. And then if you expand the practice section, there would be instructions. And based on the instruction, people code up here. So we have opened up a Grey Atom platform for a lot of free programs as well. And this can be a great value add for your learners, where they could just come into the platform and at least start on their journey to learning Python, to learning a lot of these great stuff. We are going to share with you the link here. I'm pasting the link to our free programs here as well. So that's the GLabs platform.
Great. Perfect. We already had a look at Loom, this tool particular thing. Great. So it seems the training placement officer is happy at this point in time, and we can also make out the same thing from the chats that we're also getting at this point in time. Quickly moving ahead, but before we end, I think, how is the future? What does it look like? So we'd just like to show you something. This is completely out of what we typically do. But say something like, say, this is nothing but a whole host of ready-made functionality that is there, available online. Things like emotion recognition, things like your gaze estimation. Someone spoke about, where you look, what is your interest level in the class. I think what is happening over here is a lot of people are raising hands. There is a raise hand feature in Zoom. Why can't you just actually raise your hand in front of the camera, and the camera says that this person is raising his hand and I want to talk to this person? Why can't it be more intuitive? And that is absolutely possible. And just wanted to quickly show you that, the future is this. This is the future. This is right here. This is happening. This is going to happen 4 years ahead of time because of what has just happened. And let's just quickly have a look at the demo. Say this particular person. And this is the face that is detected. This can be your face, this can be my face. And I can upload my face right away and show it to you that I'm happy and sad. So this is a surprise kind of a thing. And this is not state of the art, or this is not sci-fi, this is happening. And someone will build this mainstream into a product, which is an educational product. Maybe Grey Atom will build this in time to come. So what we're just trying to say is that the future is here. The future is happening a lot faster than we think. And there's a lot of possibility with respect to all these things. So everything that you've been thinking with respect to sci-fi is going to happen very, very, very soon. Awesome. So we have reached the very much the end. Mandar Avariya hai, thank you so much for your time. I think we just have a few more minutes of your time that we will occupy. And we will just kind of quickly move on from here. Thank you so much. So again, I just promised that this is going to be another few minutes. I know this is 5:09, but I'm just taking an effort to quickly rush through some of these things. Great. So guys, we are back to our normal avatars. Actually, I like this avatar because I had a lot more hair in this, but yeah, I'm back to where I am. And guys, that's Grey Atom for you. Grey Atom is at this point in time, continuing to grow. And we are doing a lot of community initiatives, and that's what we want to also continue to do, keep on giving back. So guys, this is one particular thing. I want to quickly do a shout out over here. I think I saw Swapnil, Professor Swapnil Gramopadhyay. I think he's in the session, or he was in the session at least. This is a student from SBGI, that is Sanjay Bokhre Group of Institution. And he is what we call as a learning champion. He actually took a session in the batch that he was part of, and he was teaching his fellow students. I don't think we have the time to go through this particular thing at this point in time. Coming to the end, guys, we have a 5-day bootcamp that's coming up. We are very much talking to the Governing Council at MATPO to make this thing happen. This is absolutely free of charge for the students across this particular wonderful body, across the state and also through this particular country. There's going to be a 5-day program where we teach people something very finite but something useful. At the end of this particular program, the student will know whether he wants to go deeper in this particular field or not want to go deeper in this particular field, and definitely would have learned something. Plus, the student will have access to the program, access to the platform, and he would also would have discovered his learning style. Great. We've done this in the past. We've had some really, really interesting response in time to come. I'll just quickly share a quick thing. people have really enjoyed these sessions in the past, and this is all public right now, available on LinkedIn. We can go and have a look at this particular thing. Great, awesome. So guys, this is the part which I like the most. I like to give you homework. So everything is here in a very light kind of a humor. I'm very respectful of all the professors and sirs and HODs. I actually also saw one of my professors from my college, Dr. Vinit Kotak. Dr. Vinit Kotak, if you're still there, I'm really happy to see you here. And great. So again, so guys, video ask is one tool. We all saw Sudarshan sir play it out in front of the camera. He recorded a video, put together a few options, and you know, see how that whole thing goes. I want you all to sit in front of your mobile, sit in front of your laptops, sign up for this tool called as Video Ask. It is free. It is free. The free tier is very strong over here. Put together a small video where you are reaching out to your questions, and you're just reaching out to your students, and you're asking them a question. How is lockdown treating you? You know, if you can gauge their sentiment, even if MLTPO can do this at the central level, that would be awesome also. And give them a multiple choice, just two or three options. You know, I'm good, I'm not okay, I'm like really feeling very bad, whatever it is. What I want you to discover is that I think it's a very interesting channel. I'll take 30 more seconds. My father was a salesman with Castrol, and all his life he used to receive memorandum from his office based out of Mumbai. And he used to collect that physical paper. At some point in time in his life, he got a pager. And then later on, he started using a cell phone. From a memo to a cell phone. And these days, the Castrol salesmen actually have a tablet. So I'm not sure what people do with tablet in garages and sell, you know, people. But they have become tech savvy. Even a salesman selling lubricants and greases has become tech savvy. It's time that we also upskill. We kind of get this whole thing up and running. So great. I think that was the whole thing. Thank you so much for your time.